Our ship is listing and may fall. Recordings reveal the frantic ship-to-shore communications as a ferry filled with 476 people, most of them students, begins to list and take on water. At 9:10, VTS, the center that monitors ship traffic, asks, "How are the passengers doing?" The ferry replies, "It's too listed and they are not able to move." 15 minutes later, panic sets in. The ship radios. If passengers escape, can they be immediately rescued? Patrol ship should arrive in 10 minutes. 10 minutes. Yes, 10 minutes. 10 minutes. The chaos and confusion all add up to an unthinkable crime, according to the president of South Korea. The actions of the captain and some of the crew are absolutely unacceptable, she says. Unforgivable actions that are akin to murder. The captain, who is facing 5 criminal charges, spoke about safety 4 years ago in a promotional video. As long as you follow the orders of our crew members, he says, traveling by ship is safer than any other means of transport. Now, that very captain faces tough questions about the orders he gave as his ship quickly sank. I gave orders to evacuate, he says, but that was after he told them to wait, because the rescue boats had not arrived yet. Most of those who obeyed are still missing, trapped inside the sunken ferry. And with each passing hour, the likelihood of a survivor being found fades. It is a reality that weighs heavily on the divers. We cry every day and search for the missing people, says a volunteer. So far, they have only recovered bodies. One by one, they are brought ashore. They are 15, 16, and 17-year-old students, parents, and children. A national tragedy. And for the families, a grueling wait for answers.